us, we, the people. We are the stakeholders, you, me. We have to battle higher than where we're battling now. We have to go after our politicians, because our politicians know who the crooks are. They know the banks are the crooks. They know that the corporations are the crooks. We know that Kamala Harris has put in a Bill of Rights to save our homes. But what you don't know is the banks are already moving ahead to move them homes into the slush fund of our hedge funds. Nip Romney's kind of people, these investors. So they can say, well, you can't come after us. You have to go after the hedge fund people. These are private investors, the ones that just bought this house. It's gonna be up to us to do the things that we have in our power. And the most power we have is the power to vote. To get out there and put those politicians that are not supporting us, their constituents, on the streets. Get them out of their luxury seats where they sit up and make decisions for us. And the decisions for us is, well, let's just let them go through the process of losing their homes. Let's just get bankrolled from these lobbyists that comes through the state capitol. I was up at the state capitol when Kamala Harris was putting that law in. She was fighting to get it in. Do you know how many lobbyists I seen going into these senators' offices? I mean, you've got five guys from Comcast wearing three-piece suits going in there to polish their hands to get more contracts. So, hey, what do we do as people? We're the ones that put them in that office. We're the ones that have to, we can put them out of that office. All we have to do is use the power that we have, and that's the power to vote. We're living in the San Francisco with a living wage that is beneath the living wage. How are we gonna get that improved? By using the power to vote. Now, if we don't get out here and start making ourselves known by being stakeholders in our communities, by fighting for these kind of people, the seniors, the elders, the veterans, the ones that are out here, and for ourselves. The only way we're going to do it is use the power that we have. Because if we go as one, we are none. But when we organize and we strategize, when we sit down and come together as a unit, as a group, and then we start talking about what we want to do, and then we implement. I call it organize, strategize, and implement. We go out and do it. We've had a lot of success with the foreclosure fight. You know, we don't win everything, but we've had big successes because we organize, strategize, and implement. How you attack the corporate world is you hit them in the head. How you hit them in the head? You don't go after the little office workers. You go after the CEOs. You go to their homes. You go to their jobs. You stand out there like we're standing out right here. That's it. Go to their church, wherever they stay, and let it be known that they are predators of people. They are predators of children. They are predators of veterans. They are predators of seniors. This is what we have to do. If you want to be heard and you want to be seen, you're going to have to stand up and do some things that you never thought you'd do before. Right. So look, I'm going to leave that. I didn't come to talk. I just came to support. And I'm just glad that I do see a lot of people here. Your word, when you go out and you leave here and you talk to a friend, you know, you let that friend, my sister here said it, you know, we have to stand up and do something as a group, a unit. We have to unify in our organizations and make one big move at it. You know, they're not gonna hear us if we just stand around and we do little things. We have to do some big things to be seen and heard. So, hey, God bless everyone. And hey, I am glad that I came here to support you. I thank you, Starbucks, for putting it on the air.
All right.